shop Yamcuts, talk, whatever it's called.
I believe it's a good idea. I believe it's a good thing. Obviously, there's been a little publicity going on in the media, but I mean, I think it's a good thing that we're doing. It definitely gives the older guys and guys like that are still here an opportunity, you know, to talk and have fun. And I think Coach Saban really enjoys it too, so it's a good thing.
How many of the players have tried it out yet?
I'm pretty sure almost every one of us has been in there to get a haircut. So,
what does that add? You know, obviously it's kind of a recruiting tool a little bit, but what does that add to the current players outside of just being able to get a haircut, you know, whenever you want?
It's a good thing. It's awesome. I mean, it's so convenient. You know, everybody's. You know, we obviously have a lot of obligations here, so that obligation being something that we don't have to go to, like don't have to go outside, you know, to go get a haircut. We can go right here on Mondays. It's a good thing.
Can you practically live here?
Pretty much. This is pretty much where we reside, even on our off days. If you don't have anything to do, you're like, well, might as well go to the complex and sit there and get some treatment or something.
First up, top that off.
What was last season like, just for you?
It was a blessing, one word. It was truly a blessing. I mean, the guys that I've been surrounded with, it's just been awesome. And I love every single one of the guys that have been here. That whole year was just truly a blessing. I mean, we had six linebackers go down, in a year, like unheard of, and we still, persevered and won a national championship. So, man, it's just truly a blessing. I mean, that year was awesome.
Did you learn anything about yourself, or just like, what it's like to be able to be ready?
I mean, you need to be ready at all times. I mean, if last year wasn't a testimony for that, I mean, I know you have some freshmen. People say that if you come to Bama, you won't play. I mean, well, look what happens, Who would expect six guys at one position to go down? So you have to be ready at all times.
How much was that kind of an opportunity? And how much, I mean, you never want teammates to go down, obviously, but how much did you approach that when your number was called? That was your chance to do something and impress your coaches with the opportunity.
Yeah, so, I mean, my role increased dramatically. I went from playing, maybe 10 snaps a game to playing 40 snaps a game. So, I mean, my role increased dramatically, and I just wanted to go out there and show that, that I was ready for this opportunity, that I wanted to do this opportunity, not just for me, but not to let the guys that got injured down, That was a big thing for me. Like, I mean, I wore those guys' number on my, wrist and hands every game. So I just didn't want to let those guys down because I know what they put in to get to this moment. I know they would, kill to be out here. So I don't want to let those guys, I didn't want to let my teammates down.
Christian mentioned, some of the linebackers not getting in-game action last year. Does that make these scrimmages more important for the core?
Indeed. I mean, like I said earlier, the scrimmages are the closest thing you can get to a game. So the coaches are not on the field for you, making calls for you. The coaches aren't correcting you. You have to go out there and you have to read and react to actual play calling. So it's very detrimental to, to get those scrimmage plays because they teach you how to play in the game.
Where do you think this defense is right now, and how has Coach Saban challenged you guys?
Well, we definitely have some improving to go. I mean, but that's why we practice. If we didn't have to improve, we wouldn't practice. So I definitely think that we're headed in the right direction. And these guys definitely have the want to and the will to want to be great. We just have to put that into action.
Scrimmages are glorified practice. Mm-hmm. Obviously, controlled situations for the most part. But do y'all as players approach it that way, or do you want it to be a game where the coach is going to watch the tape and evaluate you that next day kind of thing?
Well, pressure makes diamonds. So putting that pressure on yourself and those coaches putting that pressure on you to make it as real as of a game as possible, that's the best thing that we can do here. So I think that scrimmages are so important to us.
What do you think you do best on the field? What's your best attribute?
Me personally?
Yeah.
I don't like to talk about myself very much, but I would just say leadership. I mean, I like to show my leadership. I'm not much of a, rah-rah guy. I don't want to, tell people to do this and tell people to do that by speaking. I love to show by actions, but also leading by, speaking as well. It's part of it, but yeah, I would say leadership would be something that.
Totally different positions, but did you kind of lean on Levi last season, or did you guys kind of work similar backgrounds? Did you guys kind of lean on each other last year?
Levi's always been one of my, greatest friends since we first got here. So, I mean, Levi was a great example, of a player of hard work paying off. So, I was blessed to have Levi as a friend.
That's true. I think we asked at least five guys who's your best friend on the team, and they all said you. How do you have time to do that?
Oh, well, that's very humbling. I didn't know that they said that, but I mean, I just try to be, the best version of myself that I can be. I'm really humbled that those guys said that. I mean, I love everyone on this team. I'm so thankful for them.
What kind of personality is Josh Kasher?
He's a comedian and a hard worker all in one. I don't know how you put that. He's a comedian, hard worker, and I don't know. Cash is, he's a one-of-a-kind. He's a one-of-a-kind guy. I love him.
What kind of stories do you have about him being a comedian?
I just keep those in the locker room. We keep those in the locker room.
Any PG you can share? Is it nothing?
He's just a genuinely funny guy.
My boy. What's up with y'all there?
And Reggie Ragland is a genuinely funny guy as well.
He great. Y'all are good at him. I see you feeling up right there. I see you.
My brother's boy.
Well, what's the dynamic between Coach Saban and Tosh?
The dynamic, I think they work really well together. Obviously, with Coach Saban promoting Coach Tosh, I mean, that shows just how much that, you know, he believes in Coach Tosh. And Coach Tosh is probably, if not the hardest, is behind Coach Saban, the second hardest working person, you know, here at this university. I mean, this guy clearly loves the game of football and he loves his players. So I'm proud of him. I'm thankful for him as a coach. And I think he's going to do so well this year as a head coordinator.
Have you seen his responsibilities change with the elevation in quality? You know, at practice, is he more talkative, or obviously he's directing a lot more than maybe he has in the past?
He hasn't changed at all. He's been the same coach that he was as our outside linebacker coach, as D coordinator. He expects a lot out of us. He loves his players. And you can truly tell that he loves his job and he loves this game of football and he loves his team.
Does that kind of thing happen when a guy like Reggie walks in the room?
I don't know. I mean, I guess if you guys seeing that, it just shows you, I mean, the love that we do have on this team from current players and past players. So, I mean, it's just awesome to see Reggie and see players come back and, you know, and treat us the same way they did here as they do now when they're gone.
Thanks.